artificial coordinate or rectangular coordinates. That's very easy. However, this one can be expanded as Lagrangian polynomial associated Lagrangian function. Spherical harmonics. That's all functions. Okay. This one is the simplest tuning function. It can be expanded in different formats. So this function set, this function can be expanded as a linear combination of a complete function set. Here is the properties of the function set. It must be orthogonal. So this one and this one, after integration, will be zero or non-zero. Zero if m is not equal to f, m not equal to n, and non-zero m equals n. Okay? And we prefer to normalize, so we will also normal. We will normalize. This is connector delta. Connector delta. We will have at least two delta. One is connector delta. The other is Dirac delta function. We learned Dirac delta function in chapter 1, and now we will use connector delta. Connector delta is quite simple, just 0 or 1, that's it. Okay. So they must be orthogonal first. Orthogonal. So for orthogonal, we prove that it must be linearly independent function. Orthogonal. That means we are able. This one equals 0. The only condition is an equals 0. change the integration outside and submission inside. So sum of these terms integrate this one. You will see here. The only condition is this one equals Dirac delta function. That is only when change. Okay, so you just change the order, doesn't matter. If 要确实的 magnify, but summation, no more. So therefore, we found a simple relation. An will be exactly equals A minus N complex conjugate. Okay, that's the simple practice. More information. And if you don't like exponential representation, you like sinusoidal representation. Okay, that's fine. Sine, cosine. Actually, for most of the course, we always start sine, cosine, because you're familiar with sine, cosine. Exponential is not friendly at first. Exponential terms is deal with complex variables. It's not convenient at first, but later on you will find exponential terms is more convenient, much more convenient, because it has many information inside. And here you will deal with cosine sine. Complicated. We don't like it. So we will use exponential terms for almost all the cases, but here, I will still go back to sine cosine. There's the simple relation between here and here. These two representations. Exponential terms. Cosine, sine terms. Two representations. Up to you. For the practical problems, you prefer cosine sine. However, for most of the case, that's more convenient. Up to you. 50-50. Okay. Okay, so we have Fourier series in finite region. But now, let's extend to infinite the boundary from lower bound, from minus infinity to plus infinity. Then, the coefficient and this one and this one looks similar in form. Okay? Because it is not a finite length, it becomes infinite. The interval from A to infinity, we will obtain Fourier transforms. Fourier transform is 1 over square root 2 pi, 1 over 2 pi. The same. AK exponential IKXDK, f of x exponential IKXDX. Looks very, have some kind of symmetry. Okay. Actually, is KX here. Later on, we will have omega t. And later on, it will become better. These two is related to uncertainty principle. They are related. You can derive the uncertainty principle from here. Similar. Because this is the property of the wave. No matter if EM wave or meter wave, they should follow the same rule. Uncertainty principle can be derived from Fourier transform. They are correlated. So not new to quantum mechanics, but also exist in times the speed of light, four times the speed of light, five times, doesn't matter. Yeah. We can do that. And that's true. So several years ago, we submit our paper to Nature. And we have two reviewers. One reviewer said, makes sense. But second reviewer said, it's incorrect. It's 100% wrong. And then we show them, we do the experiment clear, nice and clean. And we explain the physics to them, to him. I don't know him or her, to someone. And he said, and then the reviewer said, okay, I accept, that's true. But what is the application? What do I know? How do I know every time? Faster than the speed of light. I will tell myself tomorrow. Of course, I will tell myself tomorrow. Tell yesterday. If I know something. Okay, so I don't know the application of the faster than the speed of light. But its physics is quite clear. Physics is quite clear. Okay, that's fast wave. On the other hand, slow waves are also very interesting. You can slow down the wave to zero. Zero velocity, zero speed. That's also very interesting. And zero speed corresponds to 100% transmission. And faster than the speed of light, normally, just 0.1% or 1% or 2%, the transmission is low, relatively low. Okay. So finally, I do not have the chance to publish in Nature. Okay, so actually, we still try to, we still hope that someday we have a chance to win the Nobel Prize. How to say that? Sometimes we try to make money, yeah, for students. But sometimes I think we still have a pretty good chance to win the Nobel Prize. Why? Because we use microwave to interact with material. We found something very interesting. You use your cell phone a lot. Cell phone frequency 2.45 GHz, roughly about this value. And you use cell phone over and over again. And you still use cell phone. Although it's microwave, you still use cell phone almost every day. Okay. You don't afraid of radiation from your cell phone. But you're afraid the microwave. Because somebody said microwave will generate something very not good for you. Is that true? We try to prove it's true or disapprove. Okay. Actually, we found something that is strange. Wave and material interaction is quite difficult to understand. Quite difficult to understand. We have some kind of special effect. No one knows. So we named it microwave effect. But no one knows what is microwave effect. But the result is using the microwave, using the wave, EM wave, interacting with material, we will have something new. Something new. It's still good for, I don't want to say that. Actually, very interesting. If we have time for it, maybe reiterate in Chinese again. 想的其实是不一样的。我们会以为剖分材料的物理都很清楚，不是，老实说不是，老实说真的不是。那每次我在国际会议上遇到一些很会算的人，他就跟我说，我跟你保证我会算得出来，那三个礼拜后就跟我写信，对不起，我算不出来。而且都是大师哦，都是接近诺贝尔奖得奖的大师哦。每次都跟我说可以，可是后来都说不行，你又好多个，都几乎是至少是院士以上的大师了。所以我们，然后我们自己推出来的所有理论，包括我们物理系整个做 condensed matter 老师，算出来跟实际上量到差距10倍。所有的 theoretical model 算出来的都差10倍了，可是实际上就真的不一样。例如微波处理材料，它的温度会下降200度、100度，然后时间会缩短10倍、20倍。为什么？它微波不就是热吗？那你为什么还要有这个效应？可事实上我看到的就是这样，微波处理碳纤维。缩短30倍，微波处理太阳的面板缩短30倍，为什么？有谁可以解释吗？现在没有人可以解释，但只知道很有效。微波处理咖啡豆时间缩短，那个跟那个好像不是 not exactly 相关吧？但是的确是在处理纯物质的时候，它其实会有一些。Microwave effect 或者是 EMP 有 induced 的 effect， 可是处理完之后再量它的特性，它其实材料特性 after 你还是回来一样 ，before 跟 after process 会很相似，会很相似。所以你要掌握这些东西，你就必须要仔细的量啊电磁波的材料特性。所以我们才会变成不小心就变成应该在全世界量材料特性里面最有的，包括从纳米，包括从各式各样的材料特性，我们都量。我想回答的是，微波的效应是什么？
锁定微波有什么特殊的物理性
？Actually, our field of research is millimeter wave and terahertz wave. And millimeter wave and terahertz wave, the frequency is about 30 giga or 80 giga, 100 giga, gigahertz. And terahertz wave is 100 up to 10 giga, 10 tera, okay, much higher. Later on, we found there are still many, many applications we need to use microwave. And use the microwave, you can explain, can you explain why there is no industrial process using microwave? 你现在有看到任何工业应用大量用微波吗? That's home use only, not industrial applications. No example. Communication, they use microwave, but not for processing, not use high power. Okay, the power is still high, 200 watt, 1 kilowatt. But I need to use weight to process material. Industrial. They have some battery, not that easy. Not that easy. Okay. The major difficulty is wavelengths. Wavelengths. I invite you, if you have time, you should go there. We have many posters outside. Have a look at material processing. You will find something very interesting, something new. Something unexpected. Okay. Your question is quite difficult to answer, but maybe you should have a look at the poster first. With our frequency of, actually, I don't like below 1 gigahertz, it's too simple. Not too simple, sorry. Below 1 gigahertz is shipped to electrical engineering. About 1 gigahertz here in the physics department. And visible line is somewhere between physics and optics. Somewhere between physics. Gamma ray, X-ray is still in the physics department. Okay, for example, Zhang Shili Yuan Si, he studied X-ray physics. Okay, what's next? We change x to x prime. Change x to x prime. In this one, prime. It doesn't matter. Prime. K the same. And then substitute this one into here. Substitute. So we have two integrations. First, second, and 1 over square root of 2 pi becomes 1 over 2 pi. And here, exponential ikx minus ikx prime. And this time, we have prime here, and k here. So, obviously, only when x prime equals x, they will be the same. So this one will become a completely relation. Okay, that's a simple proof. Because of this property, so they will be the completely. So you can exponential ikx is a complete function set. Second part, I change your natural question 2 is here. My change. Actually, this one is related to here. This one, you can interchange x and k. They will have the simple properties. So for k, you can derive the same result. Delta k minus k prime. Okay, that's another completely relations. 穴上，烤肉穴是非常非常的常用。OK， 头穴上，在胃上也很常用。我们在算超速的时候都是用烤肉穴，有没有算不出来？我们还用烤肉穴的吗？Because the we need the incident power and transmitted power. And this transmission will be a function of frequency. So actually, just like T, you say X, but actually you place a role just like T, just like time. We need to perform the integration. I know it's difficult to understand. Think about it. Okay. Convolution is very useful. Now, let's tell you something more useful. Useful means convenient. Frequency is related to wave number. So you can in terms of wave number or in terms of frequency. Frequency is much easier to understand because later on we prefer his press in omega or in T. In terms of T, you need a scope, 四波器. In terms of omega, you need a spectrum analyzer, 频谱分析, or network analyzer, 网络分析或者网络分析. Okay. Expensive. Very, very expensive. Very expensive. For example, just give you a number. If you want to measure frequency up to 100 GHz, you need roughly about 100 GHz. If you want to make your frequency up to 0. Very expensive. I just up to here. Each of these three terms must be separately constant. Einstein. Cosine beta y sine beta y. And this one will become exponential terms. Exponential gamma z, exponential minus gamma z. And the result will be a linear combination of this one times this one times this one. A plus B, C plus D, E plus F. And then these two times this one. Okay, that's the result. Here is an example. Separation of area. We find phi inside a charge-free rectangular box. Charge-free. And 0, 0, 0, 0, except here. Except z equals c. Okay. Z equals c.
Again, you have another.
integrate, perform an integration, and you can obtain the coefficient. This is all fun. This one takes a lot of time. Okay, so if I want to test your understanding about this one, I will assume B of x, y to be a simple variable. Otherwise, it takes about 2 hours to write down to find a solution. Okay. In the old days, professors always give you a complicated B of x and y to test your mathematical technique. But nowadays, they change the strategy. Because you can use computer. Okay. Just a moment. Let's go to the 6th floor department office to borrow a key of 123. Yeah. 123.
Thank you.
司长讨论讨论一个很重大的事情。
那你叫司长跟市长一起去爬山啊？哦，边爬边说。对啊，边爬边说。
台湾的市长就是科技部的副部长。OK， 没有太忙是吧？我还忙做很多功德，帮很多人，帮整个学术界。OK， the class will be changed to online learning. I will upload the video to YouTube. You can learn by yourself. That will be related to chapter 3. And there will be Lagrange equation, associate Lagrange equation, and Fredholm harmonics. Let's open the door first. Chapter 3. This morning I come here, I come to your physics department very early at about 7 o'clock. I try to prepare everything. Okay. Because tomorrow I have another meeting with another president. Okay, from our department. We actually use Chinese because we want to recruit you guys. 我们有另外一位退休的教授叫寇崇山，他现在是四家公司的总经理跟董事长。四家公司，他刚退休三年。他一直跟我说，可不可以鼓励一些学生们去他们公司？我说当然可以啊。OK， 现在就告诉你，我本来想举办一个活动，可以大家一起去他们公司参观的。好，在湖口，在台南有四家公司，他很需要人，很需要认真的好人，经过我认证的认真的好人，认真的学生。是算是教授创业非常成功的，大部分都不太成功。Okay, next one. This is the list of the international students. Okay, after class, I want to help the international students because you have a language barrier. Thank you.
It's a power in charge attracted rather than repelled by the charge field. So we can use method of images in order to solve this problem. So this is conductor sphere. You can, in order to use method of images, you need to grab this sphere. So right now the sphere is at zero potential. You can use method of images to solve this problem. So we already run this thing in our lecture. So you can directly use this formula. So it's in section 2.3. So here, this is the situation. We have a charge Q. In our problem, the distance between the center of the sphere and charge is D. Here it is Y. And because of this term, an image charge Q dash is formed inside the sphere. So you guys already know how to do this thing because this is derived in the lecture term. So in our problem, we need to calculate the distance where the attractive force between the charge and conductor becomes repulsive. So that means initially we have an attractive force between the charge and conductor. After a particular distance, this attractive force will become repulsive. So after a particular point, which is separated at a distance d. So we will put q into q, a q into q, then you can just take a polynomial equation like this, the power of 5. So you need to solve this polynomial equation. So after solving this equation, you can just get d divided by r is equal to 1.61802. So we can say that at this ratio, when d by r equals to 1.61 into 8.03, that magnitude force will become